Steve Poole, Renaissance man from the Narrows. What do you think, buddy?
Well, I'm excited to be here and to be the bodyguard of Scott Record on this trip. Make sure everything goes as it's supposed to go.
And a nice little welcome to the Oasis of the Seas. We start off by checking in at the peer coordinator's desk in the brand new terminal built just for the Oasis, with over 6,000 possible passengers per voyage. RCI has over 90 agents to make boarding the Oasis quick and hassle-free. When we get on the ship, my pal Steve Poole had quite an interesting little room scenario. Let's get to the story behind the story.
Well, the scenario was when I came on, I went to my room, the key didn't work, so I came back up to the concierge. No problem. Could be that the key was demagnetized, so there should be a new key. Went back to the room, still didn't work. I came back up and they said, oh, we'll issue you another key. We'll check you out and check you into the room. I went down there, this time the key worked, but there was already luggage in the room indicating that somebody had taken that room. Then when I came back up, Scott came down and helped me, and we learned that I was going to be bunking with a person named Brian. And Scott called the director of entertainment, and he came up and helped us out, and now I'm waiting to get into a new room.
Did you go to that room already?
So I went to that room and the key didn't work.
All right, so.
The Royal Promenade. Truly a sight to behold. The Royal Promenade is a wide cobblestone street, most of five deck. It's three stories plus high. Unbelievable, loaded with retail stores, a British pub, Sorrento's Pizza, ice cream parlor, the Schooner Bar. It's on and on and on and on. Totally amazing. Two floors of stores. And here I am sitting in Sorrento's Pizza Parlor, and it reminds me of when I lived in New York City on the Upper West Side. You go to Columbus Avenue and hang out and look at the hustle and bustle of New York. Well, this is the hustle and bustle of the Oasis of the Seas. It's just incredible. Now, this is the Opus Dining Room, the main dining room for all passengers on the Oasis. Now, there are many other dining opportunities on this ship, which I will address in another video blog. Now this room goes way back, very elegantly, the full 210 feet of width of the ship. From port to starboard, they even have an incredible blurry chandelier. Now I am looking over a balcony to the fourth floor, another floor of dining. And below that, yet another. So that's Opus 5, Opus 4, and Opus 3. For the utmost in dining for over 2,000 people at one sitting. Go up to 17 deck, the highest deck on the ship, the Viking Crown Lounge. A beautiful, beautiful lounge, the full width of the ship, the highest point of the ship, and as you look out, it's just amazing. You can look down and see Central Park, you can see the pools. There's an adult pool off to the left. And a kiddie pool with all kinds of crazy water toys on the right. And if you look off in the distance, you'll see it's a cruise ship, believe it or not. I mean, after looking at us, that's a cruise ship. We bring that along just to put our employees, give them a place to sleep at night.